Poor Rudy Giuliani just can't catch a break, can he, folks? It was reported recently that three of Rudy Giuliani's good friends, the friends in Ukraine that he relied upon to give him all the dirt on President Biden, right? Oh, we're going to take Biden down. I got these Ukrainian sources. Y'all remember all of that, right? Well, those sources have now been charged by the Ukrainian Secret Service with treason. Because it turns out, according to the charges against the men, they were actually working for an organization that was, in fact, being funded by Vladimir Putin to discredit Ukraine on the national stage. So, oops. Looks like Rudy Giuliani was actually working with a bunch of people who were being paid to convince the rest of the planet that Ukraine was a corrupt hellhole, and Rudy Giuliani fell right into the trap. Here's what happened. Ukrainian member of parliament, Alexander Dubinsky, ex-Ukrainian lawmaker Andrei Derkach, and ex-prosecutor Konstantin Kulik are suspected of joining an organization founded by chief members of Russia's military intelligence while Giuliani worked to dig up dirt on President Joe Biden and his son Hunter Biden in 2019. The organization received more than $10 million from the Russian Federation to discredit Ukraine on the international stage. And according to the charges against the men, it is established that on the instructions of the Russian Special Services, it organized events to discredit the image of Ukraine in the international arena in order to worsen diplomatic relations with the United States and complicate Ukraine's accession to the European Union and NATO. Giuliani met with Dubinsky and Derkach in Kiev in December 2019 as part of his documentary series with One America News Network on election meddling, hoping to discredit the presidential election results. So, the men who were saying, yeah, there was this prosecutor, right? And he was really good. And then Biden was like, you got to fire him because my son's on the board over here at this company that's being investigated. Giuliani comes back to America with all that. But it turns out, based on this report, that it was coming from three men that were being paid by Russia to make Ukraine look bad. So it's all bogus. Y'all don't realize how big of a deal this is, do you? This discredits everything. Every single thing that Republicans have said about Joe and Hunter Biden at this point is garbage. It came from people that were committing treason to make Ukraine look bad. And yet here we are with the House of Representatives still pushing for Biden to be impeached because of this crap. This story, which for the record now has been out for a full week, was barely a blip on anybody's radar. This should be the biggest story in the United States for the past week, for God's sakes. But it's not, because that's how our media works, right? It's a little bit complicated, right? It's a little bit murky. If you're going to talk about Ukraine, you got to talk about the war, not, you know, the corruption of the Russian government paying people in Ukraine to make Ukraine look bad, no? This is ridiculous. Like, I'm actually pissed off that this story has not gotten more legs. Because it completely discredits everything Republicans have said about President Biden and his son Hunter. And, more importantly, it shows the lengths to which what Russia will go to interfere in U.S. elections. Both of those kind of seem like pretty important things, don't you think? Ring of Fire has fresh content 7 days a week, so if you want to be reminded about it, don't forget to subscribe to the channel, hit the little bell to be notified every time a new video goes up.